Well, hello everyone. Today is the last day of admin of code for 20 of tw for 2020. We're only 2.5 minutes out, so hopefully things go well today. And yeah, hopefully it's a good problem as well. I have definitely been a little bit disappointed with the difficulty of the problems this year. They've been too easy. Actually, earlier today was going back and looking at some of the problems from previous years, and I solved a few from 2018, I think, and they're much, much harder, or at least slightly more involved. So yeah, it's been it I think it's been overall an enjoyable experience, especially being able to have this live stream and having other friends who are discussing it as well. It's been pretty great. But I would like it, the problems to have been harder. Okay, here we go. 20 seconds out from the last day of Advent of Code for the year. So where does this? To itself multiplied by the subject number. Loop size must be 8 because transforming the initial subject of number of 7 with a loop size of 8. To transform a subject number, start with 1, then a number of times called the loop size. So it's n times the subject number, so the value to the remainder after. So it's just mod this guy, right? And this is our loop size, and then we just need. So, what's the subject number? I just assume that it's 7? Okay, hold on. So the subject number of. So what am I given? Are these the public keys? I'm so confused. Public key. Public key. Subject number with a loop size of 8 produces the encryption key. Okay, so Do we, okay, is this always the number that we're supposed to use? So let's just see if this works. Okay, I see. Okay, so what, So, let's just do. Do we all just do 7? How do I find the loop size? This is what's confusing me. Card's public key is this. So 7. What the heck? So the example is this? What? I'm still so confused by what this means. Am I supposed to use the subject number of 7 all the time? Congratulations, Joshua. Oh, I see. Wait, this. I see. I feel really retarded now, but that's a common feeling. Loop size of 8 and loop size of 8. Well, that's pretty easy to just solve. Oh. Wait, that's bad. Disaster. Oh. I thought the subject, wait, so the subject matters, subject number, I really don't understand anything. Going on. This problem is like very poorly worded. I'm not impressed. So I'm supposed to use 7? What am I supposed to do with this? So I'm just supposed to use 7 all the time? And then... But when, where am I supposed to pull in the public keys? I really don't understand this, guys. Because it says that the public key... loop size of 8. Let's see. Wait, so I'm supposed to use this 7 still? Do I need to make this faster? Okay. So it finds it here. And then what am I supposed to do? Well, he couldn't have worded it more confusingly. So why doesn't this work? Just slow? Oh. Why is exponentiation so slow? So I guess I'm gonna have to solve this equation, eh? So x to the ls equals 2020 equals how am I supposed to do this? Wait, O of loop size? I mean, isn't this O of loop size? Like, transform is just constant time, right? I guess exponentiation is hard. Thanks, Mikranda. I think that's blatantly obvious. Frick. Oh, McPanda, I don't care. I agree. This is like mainly just me being incompetent. So what the frick am I supposed to do? This is like a not very. Just let's look at Wikipedia. Where's E? Oh, I see. What is B? B times C mod M. What is where's M? Oh, this guy. FE prime less than can't assign to literal. Oh, it would help if I, wrote it right. Okay, so now B is undefined. Where do I get B from? Oh, that's SN. Mean, this is still O of E, though. How is this any better? How am I supposed to do this? McPanda, don't worry. I'll figure this out eventually. Do I need this? I wonder if okay, I need to figure out a way to make, I guess, transform faster. Don't get it. Yeah, so I actually earlier did some problems from 2018. And they're way better than this year. Like, I was doing like day 6 and day 7 and I'm actually enjoying myself. So Chad is saying that I should just stare at this for longer. Oh. And then what am I supposed to do? Transform the subject number with the loop size of... I see. I do have to... LS2 equals E prime. All right, let's ban this person here. There we go. I mean, has Colin actually, does he actually need to solve tonight? I guess he does. Okay, what the frick? What am I doing with my life? Well, this fast enough? Why isn't it? What is wrong? Seems suspicious. This is still gonna be slow AF. Okay, so how do I extract this? Is it just C? Should I just keep going? I'm so confused. Okay, so it's just being slow with this. Well, that sucked. I'm pretty sure this storm is a representation of how this problem went for me. Well, frick. Yeah, I don't know how you guys solved this so quickly. I'm just stupid, I guess. That's really the answer to most of my questions. Okay, so how do we make this integrate this n? Because you can kind of like, I'm guessing that you can somehow basically, oh, I see. I'm not even gonna explain tonight, by the way. It's just not worth it. C2 and C3. Are those even useful numbers? I don't even know. They don't look useful. Why am I even doing this? I didn't even like this problem. I just hate my code so much that it's like, I don't want to leave it as it is. Okay, let me just at least extract out. Yeah, you know what? Screw it. Like, I'm just gonna commit and call it a day. I guess I'll add some slight interesting stuff here. This problem involves doing modular exponential. By the way, if Ethan is still here, congratulations. And who else has solved? Adam solved. John Taylor, anonymous user, Kashav and Jackson, but they haven't solved day 20. Day 20, the one where we had to do the flipping. McPanda, congratulations. Colin has apparently either died or is just sitting there waiting for everyone else to solve and then still gonna win. Let's see. How do I link to stuff? Memory. Yeah, I am at least happy that I did solve all of the stars. You know, that's at least one thing that went well. Everything else kind of went pretty badly. Especially tonight. Like the past like what, 5 nights or so has been just a disaster. But Adam, man, really killing it. I mean, Colin's always going to do well, but like, I don't know. This streak since day 19 has just been a catastrophe. have to. Yeah, so we have to check it against two public keys, and if and once we have the e prime corresponding to each of the we can just exit the loop. Okay. Yeah, unfortunate problem. Really quite unfortunate. There is no part two. And we can get rid of a bunch of, I mean, we can get rid of everything basically in this. Yeah, I gotta say, wording on this, 0 out of 10. Actual problem was okay if this was day like two. But it wasn't. It was day 25. So, okay, well, I mean, I can't complain too much about the problems, you know. I do know that it takes a lot of work to write problems. Having written many problems myself, it's non-trivial, but I am disappointed in the difficulty. Nonetheless, very, 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 very annoying. Yeah, so this is effectively, as Josh was saying in chat, like this is effectively cracking Diffie-Hellman, except for worded in about as convoluted a way as is humanly conceivable, and with very, very small keys. Right, like, I mean, these are only, you what? Is it really? It may actually literally just be straight up to Diffie-Hellman. Is it? I don't know. Somebody should tell me. I mean, it didn't even register with me like that it would be an actual cryptographic strategy. But okay, so let's like look at this thing, right? Like, so like 24 bits. Okay, so I think that this one was that's pretty funny. Like if you were a crypto person and saw that this was like hard and knew that this was a hard problem and didn't look at your input, then you might have really panicked. But like these are, you know, 23 bits, just not a big number, you know, considering Diffie-Hellman is with what, at least 1024 to 20 48 bit keys, like it's nothing. Which is why it's important, kids, to well, absolute disaster. Which is why it's important to I don't know what it's important to do. Oh yeah, not implement your own crypto. Yeah, I don't know, whatever. Disappointing day on all fronts. Where are these Easter eggs? Ah, I see. That's kind of fun. Yeah. Josh was like, this is why it's important. This is why it's not important. It's important not to study cryptography. I agree. This one was one of those days where it was like, just don't do anything smart. Except, I mean, you do have to know about this, I guess, right? Fast exponentiation. Or you have to just not be stupid like me. And I guess if you just thought of it as literally how he describes it, then it makes sense. Like this is literally what he just describes. I guess that would also be the way. Yeah, whatever. Okay. Definitely, definitely disappointed. So wait, John Taylor solved 20. He was in this group that hadn't solved 20 yet. So, wow. Which is basically more or less 100 points. Okay, I don't know. I don't know what to say about this day. I can't really explain this to you because I just like bungled my way to it. So probably go talk. Probably literally go to anybody else's stream and they'll explain it better. What a pathetic way to end this, man. Look at this. Least, I don't know. Oh, I bet there's a lot of people who haven't solved a previous problem, and that's why. Whatever. If you're on YouTube, give it a thumbs up and a like and subscribe. Who knows if I'll ever stream again? I'll probably stream next year. For Advent of Code. So if you subscribe, then you'll be notified when I do start doing that. And you should come over and follow me on Twitch because I may do stuff there over the next year if I feel like it. But until then, have a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.